Next from us, a photographer from Northampton is back in the UK after capturing the highs and lows of the Winter Olympics in PyeongChang.
Clive Mason began his career at the Northampton Chronicle and Echo in 1988 before joining Getty Images in 1994.
Well, he now travels the world in search of incredible sporting moments. Today, our reporter Liz Summers and cameraman Jonathan Stevens turned the lens on him.
Reflecting on the thrills and spills of the Winter Olympics in PyeongChang, Clive Mason now back at home in Northampton after capturing all the action in South Korea. The sports photographer who began his career at the Northampton Chronicle and Echo now works for Getty Images.
I love the Winter Olympics. It gives you an opportunity to do sports that you wouldn't necessarily cover on a day-to-day basis. You know, the variety is immense. We get the opportunity to float around and take different pictures from ski jumping to the alpine to the sliding centre to cross country. I think you've got colour, you've got speed, you've got athletes competing at the very, very top of their game. All these things that you don't necessarily do on a daily basis make it just a lot of fun to photograph.
PyeongChang was Clive's fifth Winter Olympic Games. He's been to every one since Salt Lake City in 2002. He's photographed lots of winning moments, often in difficult conditions. But when it comes to British competitors, it's always special.
Having seen Amy Williams win skeleton gold in Vancouver in 2010 and seeing Lizzie Arnold's success at the previous Olympics, I thought, wow, it'd be great to be on the skeleton final. And my assignment editor made sure I was on the final there, so I was there to witness not only Lizzie winning her gold, but also Laura Dias winning her bronze. And it was just a fantastic evening. It was great to be there as a Brit and great to see the success.
Clive's no stranger to success himself. He's won countless awards for his photography over the years. And there may well be more to come with a busy schedule ahead.
I do look forward to the Formula One, which we go to Australia, I think, 2 weeks today, I think, for the first race of the year. And then before we know it, will be May, June time, and then it's a World Cup in Russia. Which I'm also lucky enough to be involved in. I'll do the group stages of the World Cup in Russia and then I'll come back after the groups and do Wimbledon fortnight. And then it'll be more Formula One and then it'll be Christmas.
Blink and you'll miss these magic sporting moments. Thanks to Clive and his camera, they'll stay with us forever. Liz Summers, ITV News, Northampton.
Fantastic skill. I have no idea how he actually managed to keep his lens still in PyeongChang. Minus 25 for some of those.
Absolutely shivering. Yeah. Absolutely. Right, let's see what's coming up on the rest of your news hour with Mary.